So I've got the composition, my still life set up exactly the same way that it was before. Really just looking at the direction of the light. The main light that I'm using is sort of coming from this way, the natural light through the windows. I do also have some lights above as well, but I can see the casting a shadow this way. So that's the main source of light, is through the windows over there. So I'm going to start with this little fox here, and start to build up some different colours on that. Really looking at where I've got light and dark. So I can see this bit here is quite dark, and then getting sort of a little bit lighter here, whereas I can see some of the light is picking up some of these parts on his face at the front. So I'm going to go in with a little bit of the red, just around the edge here, and then start to blend that out. So lightening up my pressure to go into the orange. And get a nice smooth blend. And then even on this tail part here, although the majority of it's white, I've got a little bit of some other colours in there, slightly darker. So I'm just going to go in with a little bit of this brown, just to pick up some of those sort of shadows just there, and then blend that out with the white. Need to be careful I'm not picking up some of that orange as well. Grab that line again. And then I'll build round to the rest of the fox's face there on this pot. And now I can go back in and look really where it is lighter and darker. Definitely darker on this side from my view. And much lighter on that side, so I'm just going to try and leave some gaps where I can see the light hitting it from there. And I could either leave them just as they are, or I could just smooth them through with a little bit of the white. Important to remember, obviously the white won't go over any of the other colours, so that's why it's a good idea to leave a little bit of that white paper there. Again, this part here I can see a slight shadow just at the bottom there, the bottom of mine from the angle I'm at here. I'm just going to give a slight shadow line just there. Do you need to make sure that your pastels are clean. I'm just going to wipe off that one, or you can always turn it around to the other side to make sure that you're not accidentally getting any other colours that may still be left on there. You can just wipe it off, or use another bit of your paper to get that through. Let's pick up a little bit of the orange there, but not too much. And now I'm just going to go in with my little details, being careful that my hands aren't getting too messy. I'm not ending up leaning in and rubbing my design away. I'm going to blow off the excess rather than rub it off, just so it doesn't go into the wrong place. And I'm now going to continue again with this part here. I'm trying to get those areas that are darker. Use a little bit of the brown. I can see on each of these tips there's a little bit brown on some of them. In the angle I'm looking at, just here, I'm going to go in with a little bit of brown on each of those, remembering my observation skills, constantly looking, because actually that one I can't see any brown on that one there, in the angle I'm at. And then I'm going to go in with my next darkest colour. I always try and go in with the darkest colour first, and then fade it out. And now in with my lightest green shade. And then I can just go back and add any detail that I feel like I've missed or lost on those shapes. So I'm going to go in with the jug and start to build up some of the colours there. I'm going to start with the centre, which again you probably can't see quite as clearly in the video, where I can see inside the jug. So I'm going to start off with my darker colour again. So I'm going to go in with my dark blue. And start to pick up some of that again, constantly looking. Definitely lighter there, sort of sweeps up. And again, it's very light on the edge there. Where the one light hits it there again, need to leave a little bit in order for me to go over that with my white there. Getting quite light here, so I'm going to try and keep that with some gaps on it. I can see sort of the light shining just on the top here. I'm going to try and leave that, and then there's a few sort of spots of light, and it's definitely dark around this side, so I'm going to go in really gently this side. And then start to build up some of that colour in the centre, a bit darker, looking at where the light's coming through. And then there's a little bit of light sort of coming from this side. And then there's a really dark part here where actually it's catching the reflection of the handle there. Okay, so because you've smudged that a little bit, so that's why it's really important just to keep your hands clean as best as you can. Okay, so what I'm going to do for the really dark parts is just use this red. So just really for those shadows, just to give it that sort of purpley tone to go through. Okay, once I'm happy with that, I can move on to my final part, which is going to be the pen pot that I've got here. And I'm only going to use the dark blue, but I may use the red as well to pick up some of those shadows. Again, looking for those dark and light points. So again, my angle is slightly different, but from my angle, I can see this side of the pen pot, and that's really quite dark. So I'm going to go in with a very light red layer first. That will help me add some darkness to that. Again, trying to look at where the light hits it, I can see a little bit from here where the light's catching that little bit of paper there. And I feel like I want to make this part just darker. So I'm just going to go over that with the red again. Could use the black. I'm just going to try and avoid using that too much. And then I'm just going to try and blend that through with my white just to get that impression of where the light is hitting it. Just there. That's my dark blue and just blend that bit through. Get a bit of a smoother blend. Okay, and final part here, I'm just going to add my details on my pens. Again, trying to pick up the light in the dark, darker just behind that clip of the pen. And then again, darker on this side just here. Lighten that up with an orangey tone. And then I've obviously got what's left in the pot. So I'm going to go over with a bit of red just to darken that up. And then with my dark blue, that bit's going to stay white as that's the edge of that pen. So can I just go back and look and just check that I'm happy with everything, whether I want to add any more colours, wherever I feel that things are too light or too dark in certain parts. I'm going to go in with a little bit more of a dark blue just here. I feel like I haven't picked up quite so much of that colour. And again here, I feel like some of these are still quite light, a bit too white. So I can just go back and correct anything that I'm not quite happy with. So the final thing I'm going to do is just to look at the shadows. So I'm just going to create an impression of those shadows on the paper here. Looking at the shapes that those make, remembering that shadows aren't just black. So I'm first of all just going to go in with a little bit of a brown, just to give a bit of an indication as to where those shadows go. As you can see, I've got a couple of different light sources here, so I just need to be a bit careful of that. Best if you've just got one. And I can go in with brown or even a black. And again, I can soften those up just with a bit of the white. Just be mindful of that's now covered in blue from how I've used it before. So I'm just going to turn around and use the other side just to blend those shadows out.